There must have been a time, I suppose, when you thought maybe I'm going to become a flyer, an airman, a pilot.
I don't think this was until my sisters reached the flower of womanhood. One was 2 years older than me, you see, and the other one was 4 years older than me. And so I was just the kind of the scraggy little teenager hanging on their coattails.
And this would be when you were about how old?
Well, I was born in 22, so I suppose it'd be about, let me think, when I was about 14 or 15, they'd have been 17 and 19. Oh, so it'd have been earlier than that, wouldn't it?
Mm. And then this was before the war?
This was before the war, yes. This would be 1936, 37, 38, you know. And, you know, they used to come and play tennis and so on, and they'd go bathing in the mill stream. We couldn't do that now, could you? And I mean, I remember that on one occasion, there was a great snowfall, and then there was a great thaw. And somebody suggested that we should go and bathe in the mill stream. So we did, and we waded through along the river banks, up to our waist, and my mother leapt in and was swept away by the current and got caught up in an elder bush. In dived gallant RAF men and dragged her to safety. She was still clutching her pearls. I mean, that's so stupid, isn't it?
So what sort of a place did you grow up in? Sounds rather wonderful. Somewhere in the country.
It was in the country. It was Little Shelford. It was near Cambridge. And, I mean, I'd got... In my genes, I'd got a great deal of, what's the word, survivability. I mean, my father had served on Robben Island as a doctor for the prisoners there, and there were three ranks on Robben Island, which is just, you know, where Mandela was, and the one wing was lunatics, one wing was lepers, and one wing was murderers. He said it could become confused because a man could go mad and murder a leper could, you know. And so then my father decided that he would walk from the Cape to Cairo. It took him 3 years because he got black water fever in Uganda, and then he got to Cairo with a little bearer whose mother had said she couldn't keep him, would my father take him? And this little bloke said, could he go on? And my father said, no, I'm going on up to Leningrad now. And he said, it wouldn't suit you. So he gave him money to set him up with a small shop in Cairo. And that's the last I know of this Ugandan.
And your father walked?
Yeah.
To Leningrad?
Well, he walked from the Cape to Cairo, and then I suppose he took a ship or something. He was a multilinguist. He listened to all of the radio programs and reported back to the BBC. He was half Italian, and he could speak Italian, German, Russian, French, Spanish, Portuguese. And as my mother said, not one of them like a native. But quite a remarkable man.
So you got quite a lot from him.
I think I was given a good brain, but I wasn't given any athletic ability from him.